What's up guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to fix the injection failed LoadLibFail error you are getting when trying to play Roblox on your Windows PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. When trying to play Roblox, you might encounter an error message stating injection failed LoadLibFail or DLL not found. This error usually occurs due to missing or outdated files in the Roblox installation. Start by visiting the provided GitHub link in the description below. This link directs you to a page where you can download a specific version of Roblox known as RobloxUWP. Click on the download link for RobloxUWP. Once the file is downloaded, run the installer. During installation, you'll be prompted to install or reinstall Roblox. This process reinstalls an older version of Roblox that includes the necessary LoadLibDLL file, which should fix the error. It's important to ensure that your Windows operating system is up to date. Outdated Windows versions can cause compatibility issues with Roblox. Go to your Windows settings, head to the Windows Update section, and click on Check for Updates. If there are any available updates, download and install them. This may require restarting your computer. Keeping Windows updated helps maintain system stability and compatibility with games like Roblox. If the previous steps don't resolve the issue, a complete reinstall of Roblox might be necessary. Open Windows Settings and navigate to Apps. In the Installed Apps section, search for Roblox. Click on the burger menu icon next to Roblox and select Uninstall. This will remove any installed versions of Roblox, including both web and Microsoft Store versions. To delete the Roblox cache, search for %appdata% using the Start menu search. Navigate to AppData, Local. Find the folder named Roblox and delete it. Clearing the cache removes any potentially corrupted or outdated files. Finally, reinstall Roblox from the Microsoft Store. This will install the latest version of the game, which might be more stable and error-free. Remember, all these steps and more information are included in the comprehensive guide linked in the video description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.